Welcome to Yury Experience, and today I want to talk with you about the fact that I will have a conversation with a racist person. Let me tell you a story. At the end of the previous year, in the beginning of this year, I was in Israel with a program for Jewish people. By the way, thank you Birthright Israel for this opportunity to visit Israel and visit a lot of cities in Israel. And during this trip, we had a game. Some people said some sentences or some statements or some opinions, and all of us had to align ourselves depending on whether we agree or disagree with that opinion. And one of the opinions was, are you afraid of being a Jew or openly discuss being a Jew in Germany? I was running towards the direction of, I am not afraid. I disagree with this opinion. I am not afraid to discuss the fact that I am a Jew to some degree. And I thought that most of the people will share my point of view. However, I was wrong. Yet there were people who agreed with me, but also there were people who were on completely other part of the spectrum. They were afraid of discussing being a Jew in Germany. I was confused. With my background of Russia and Ukraine, it is interesting for me to hear that people in Germany also afraid of sharing their culture or sharing their nationality. Because there is this stereotype of Germany being a very tolerant country. Yes, you can find here and there some radical opinions about cultures or nationalities or races, but where not? You can find that everywhere. And in Germany, overall, in my personal opinion, it is quite good. So I tried to have a conversation with some of the people who were disagreeing or who were agreeing with being afraid. And one of the points that they said me was the fact that I am a big person, I am a tall guy, big guy, and that is the reason not to be afraid of stuff like that. And although I disagree with that, because it doesn't matter how tall you are, against 10 people you can do anything, but I kinda understand where they are coming from. That is the reason why I will always say everybody, and I will do my best to live according to this sentence, I will talk to a person who completely disagrees with me. And it doesn't matter what kind of disagreement we are talking about. Being it race, being it culture, being it religion, being it food, being it nutrition, being it sport, being it education, being it something else. It doesn't matter. I'll do my best to talk to every freaking person who is ready to talk with me about every freaking topic. Doesn't matter whether this person is actually against my existence, speaking of racists, nationalists, some anti-Semites, or even some other social groups connected to fitness or nutrition, but it doesn't matter. If these people are ready to talk with me, I will do my best to talk to them without prejudice, without getting angry, without getting impatient. I will do my best to concentrate myself and try to understand the other person. Why would I do that? In my personal opinion, and also it is not only my opinion, I've heard that opinion also from other people, if you want to have a proper discussion, you need to be able to speak from both positions. So if you want to have discussion about vegan, you shall know arguments pro-vegan and anti-vegan. Or if you want to talk about globalization, you need to have points pro-globalization and against globalization and everything else. And in order to gather these points, you can read, you can watch movies, but you can also talk to people who actually think that way, who actually support that kind of opinion. Which is why at the end of the day, if you don't have conversations with people who you are disagree with, first you live in a bubble, I'm sorry to tell you that, but you live in a bubble, and second, you will not understand them. There are no two completely equal persons in this world. There are none. Each and every person has personal reasons to be in that or different social group or political group or religious group or whatever group. Each and every person has personal reasons. And if you don't discuss these reasons with that person, you will not understand why that person does it. And maybe that person does it for completely different reasons that you have in your head. But you will never find out, because you don't talk with that person. I do understand that I will not solve all of the world problems just by talking. I am just one humble person. Okay, not very humble, but still. However, you probably have heard of one black person who came to KKK meetings and actually managed to bring, I think, more than 50 people, I will write correct number somewhere here, out of the Klan. So one person can make that much of a change. Then maybe you can make also some change. Then maybe I can make some change. And so if every person will do his, her, or their best to understand other people, to understand why their values are like that, and will try to understand why your values are like that, and be able to criticize your own set of values, because nobody is perfect, and nobody's set of values is perfect from all the points of view. So if you are able to speak to other people, independent of the fact do they agree with you or do they not, then you are, in my personal opinion, on a great start to make a change. Maybe not a huge change, but every small change makes a difference, because big change consists of small changes. So I don't want to say that you have to talk to other people, but I think it would be a good experience for you. And it is a good experience for me. That is why I will do my best to continue doing that. I assume you know where is the like button. I think you also know where is the comment section. You can write your questions and suggestions in the comment section. You can also subscribe to the channel, and except for that, I see you on Thursday.